got to meet Obama, which was amazing. Yes. Obama. Not Barack. His half-brother Fred runs a Macy's in Queens. Now, I got to meet Obama with Zach Galifianakis, who played Alan in The Hangover. Who, by the way, Zach Galifianakis is the funniest motherfucker alive. He's my favorite actor I've ever worked with because we, like Kevin Hart, we all go way back doing stand-up comedy. And when he was doing it, I always hated following him because he was always the funniest guy in the room. But here we are at the White House meeting the sitting president of the United States, and I have to follow him again. I'm like, fuck, dude. Because Zach comes with jokes, man. He comes loaded with jokes. And this is the first time Obama and Zach had met before they did the Between Two Ferns thing. So they were instantly, dude, they were on. They were simpatico. I was watching their fucking comedy kinship from the beginning. Zach whips out a $2 bill and goes, you have change for this photo session? And Obama's laughing so hard going, oh, very droll, Zach, very droll, you know? And I'm standing to the side in a suit and a tie because I'm a good fucking Asian, you know what I mean? Look, I'm standing with a suit and a tie, and I'm having what I call my Google image resting face, all right? Because when you Google image search me, you always get this. And by the way, when it says wear a suit and a tie, that's what you do. You know, Zach is such a rock star. He's wearing a t-shirt, tough skins, and some fucking Crocs. And he's like POTUS's favorite son all of a sudden. And then it's my turn. I can't follow him. I don't have jokes. I just want to do my photo and get the fuck out of there. Obama, like, look, he looks at the card. I don't know if he knows who I am. He's looking at me. I'm right there. Secret Service is right there. He goes, oh, and he does his whole draw. Oh, this is Ken. Yeah. We like Ken, don't we? I'm like, what? So I walk in, he puts his arm around me, and I'm just same face. And he's disappointed in me because, you know, unlike Zach, I'm not doing anything, you know? His exact words, come on, man, loosen up, man. You're a little stiff, man. Literally, Galifianakis comes in and he goes, this is how you entertain the president, Ken. And he and Obama proceed to verbally roast me for 5 minutes. It was a roast battle. It was like fucking Jeselnik and Ross, like fucking. It was like, they were telling me to loosen up. And I'm like, well, I suppose I could loosen up my tie, you know? And Obama, I swear to God, he said the driest to it. He said, no, I've seen your work. No nudity. It's a family affair, family show. And that's why I voted for Trump. Now, because he's a great guy, not racist, rarely tweets. I got a Trump story too, man. I could have met him. We were both booked to be on Jimmy Fallon together a couple of years ago when he was a presumptive Republican nominee and I was the second guest. And I am scared of Trump. Dude, Asians are fucking scared of Trump like Godzilla, all right? We are just fucking scared. Dude, when Trump got elected, dude, my daughter Zoe, she was just like, oh my God, do we have to bow to him? Swear to God. And I'm like, yes you do, Zoe. Get your bow game on, bitch. He's the president, all right? But I was so scared to meet. I'm literally frightened to meet him. And they're like, fucking why, dude? I'm like, think about it. Okay, stay with me for a second, all right? Dude, he's a big Hangover fan, wanted to meet me. He's seen my fucking big bush in The Hangover, all right? He's seen me naked. He sees my shiitake mushroom, you know what I mean? Just stay with me. What if he gets really horny and shit? You just don't know, horny or hangry or whatever the fuck he gets when he gets aroused. All that Access Hollywood shit came out. What if he wants to grab my almost pussy, guys? I don't want to get me too'd by the president. And that is when Ken Jeong became woke AF. You know, you don't want that. Don't worry, that's not going to make it in the special. It'll be fine. Because I don't think he's going to be around for that long, so. Swear to fucking God. When Obama is speaking, he goes, how hard is it to condemn Nazism? How hard is it after Charlottesville to condemn racism? I mean, you know, he's appeasing to his racist alt-right base and shit. Even the racists are like, dude, tone it down, Donnie. Dude, we get it. Even David Duke, whoa, say some racism for us. We get it. This is not how you're racist. For real, I was in Palm Springs, all right? 2 hours south of here, thinking that would be safe, and I got fucking heckled by a Trump white trash supporter, man. I've never been heckled by white trash before. I was just like, and it gave me no end of pleasure to say, as a minority millionaire,